must be out of your goddamn mind. Joe Louis, the greatest boxer ever lived. I'll be with you boys in a minute. He was bad in Chester Clay. He bad in Sugar Ray. He bad in that. Who that? The new boy got.
Mike Tyson
looked like a bulldog. He bad in him, too. He done whipped Mike Tyson's ass. He whipped all their asses.
What about Rocky Marciano?
Oh, there they go. There they go. Every time I start talking about boxing, a white man got to pull Rocky Marciano out their ass. That's day one. That's day one. Rocky Marciano. Rocky Marciano. Let me tell you something wonderful. Rocky Marciano was good. But compared to Joe Louis, Rocky Marciano ain't.
He beat Joe Louis's ass.
That's right. He did whoop Joe Louis' ass.
Joe Louis was 75 years old when he fought.
I don't know how old he was, but he got an ass whooped.
Joe Louis had come out of retirement to fight Rocky Marciano. The man was 76 years old. Joe Louis always lied about his age. He lied about his age all the time. One time, Frank Sinatra comes out here and sat down in this chair. And I said, Frank, you hang out with Joe Louis just between me and you. How old is Joe Louis? You know what Frank told me? He said, hey, Joe Louis 137 years old. 137 years old.
Oh, man, you ain't never meet no Frank Sinatra.
Fuck you.
Who's next?
Damn, boy, what's that, some kind of weave or something?
It is my natural hair. I have been growing it since birth.
Well, shit, what kind of chemical you got in there?
I have put no chemicals, only juices and berries.
That ain't nothing but ultra perm. Tell me how you want me to cut this.
Just make it nice and neat.
That'll be $8.
Tell me, Semmi, honestly, how do I look?
I think it is time to find your queen.
Got a secret. I worship the devil.
See, that's the problem. I can't find a man that can satisfy me. Now, some guys go hour and a half. That's it. A man's got to put in overtime for me to get off.
I'm not interested in a man unless he drives a BMW.
Yeah, well, you know, baby, I'm almost single. My husband's on death row.
This is the first date Teresa and I have been on since the doctor separated us.
I'm into the group thing.
I was Joan of Arc in my former life.
My name is Peaches, and I'm the best all the DJs want to feel my breath.
Yeah, I want to work in videos, but really I want to be my own star in the videos because I want to become a pop singer and a rock singer and write my own songs, produce my own songs. And then I want to try an actress because people tell me how talented I am. I'm a natural and stuff like that. So then I'm going to write my own stories and direct my own stories and, you know, produce the movies I'm doing.
I hope you don't mind me coming over and sitting down. But I've been watching you all evening, and I want to tear you apart. And your friend, too.
Is it my imagination, or does every woman in New York have a severe emotional problem?
I doubt we will ever find your queen.
Mr. Clarence!
Hey, the boys from Africa. How y'all doing this evening?
Sir, where can one go to find nice women here?
Oh, you got to get out and look. They ain't gonna just fall in your lap.
We have been to every bar in Queens.
Well, that's where you messed up, son. You can't go to no bar to find a nice woman. You got to go to a nice place, a quiet place like a library. It's a good woman there. And at church, it's good girls. Or this place here, where I'm going tonight, the Black Awareness Rally, it's going to be some fine women there. Good, clean girls. That's where I'm going.